Namaste, dear students. In the last few classes, we were discussing about measures of dispersion, right? In measures of dispersion, we saw range, quartile deviation, then mean deviation and standard deviation. So, in the last class, we were discussing about coefficient of variation. Coefficient of variation is the is used to compute the variability of two or more series, isn't it? So, if CV is more means that series is less consistent or their variability is more. Coefficient of variation more means variability more, their homogeneity is less or that is less consistent. If CV is less means that series is more consistent. Then better run scorer we saw. Better run scorer or better run scorer anta kelidre what we have to compute. So batsman A and batsman B is there. Who is better run scorer means we have to compute average. Average runs scored by batsman A and batsman B. And which average which x bar is more, he is more he is a better run scorer. So x bar jasti idre that he is a better run scorer. And if CV is less means CV which one is less, that is more consistent. So we will do some more problems on CV and in the coefficient of variation also. Coefficient of variation we didn't do for which one, upper, if upper limits and less than cumulative frequency given, how to compute. So just nothing is there actually, you have to convert it into class interval and frequencies first, then as usual we are finding coefficient of variation, standard deviation and x bar. Okay, we will do one problem of CV today first. So, CV in the case of continuous series, suppose in the continuous series it is asked who is more consistent or which series is more consistent. There also we are computing which one, CV first, coefficient of variation first. Okay, following is the first problem. Following is the distribution of weights of students. Distribution of weights of students. Weights of students. Full stop. Then compare their coefficient of variations. Compare their coefficient of variations. Okay. Compare their coefficient of variations. So, see here, weights in kilogram, number of students given. Weights in kilograms, then number of students. Number of students, class A, then class B. Weights 20 to 30, then 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, 60 to 70, 60 to 70. This one class A, 7, 10, 20, 20, 18, 7. Here it is 5, 9, 21, 15, 6. Okay. Compare, see, read the question carefully. Here what they asked, just they asked, following is the distribution of weights of students. We have to compare coefficient of variations. So, for computing coefficient of variation, which data given here? See, continuous series given. However, class intervals are given. If class intervals means continuous series itself. So, continuous series, here class A number of students. Class A number of students means this is frequency of first class. This is class B's frequency, isn't it? So, for computing CV, separately we have to compute CV of class A, similarly CV of class B. So for computing CV, first we have to compute a standard deviation, next x bar. Both we have to compute, next we have to compute CV. Okay, we will do separately. Can I rub this or okay, I'll write there. If no space means I'll rub this. Okay, weights. See solution. First, what we have to do? First, we have to compute. First, I am doing CV of first one, class A. So class A, class A, class A. So here weights. Weights same. Weights. Then number of students. Number of students I am writing as frequency. Class A's CV first. For computing class A's CV, I have to compute x bar and sigma or a standard deviation. Next, mid x is required. See, can we do in direct method? Direct method is easy, isn't it? I'll do in direct method itself. Direct method means f into x, that only. So, x, next, x square, next, f into x. For computing, which one? For computing x bar, sigma fx is required. For computing sigma or standard deviation, f into x square is required. Correct, na? This much columns are enough. Weights 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, next 50 to 60, 60 to 70. Next 7, 10. See, remember here, again here class A. Class A's frequency we have to consider. Don't go for class B. Class B is different. Okay, frequency is different here. Class B separately we are doing later. So, first you have to do for class A. So, 7, 10, 20, 18. Next, 7. So, mid-x, we have to compute mid-x, midpoint, 20 plus 30 divided by 2, 25, 30 plus 40 divided by 2, 40 plus 50 divided by 2, 50 plus 60 divided by 2, 60 plus 70 divided by 2. See, I am doing using direct method. You can adopt any method, no problem. If it is shortcut method, okay. If it is step deviation method also, okay, no problem. So, in step deviation method, you will get small numbers. If deviations d dash equal to x minus a divided by c. You can do in that method also, no problem. Next, x square 25 square, 625, 35, 35, 1225, 45, 45, 2025, next, 3025, next, 4225, okay. Next, f into x means this column into this column, f into x. So, 175, f into x, next, 350, next, 900, next, 990, next, 455. Hope this much clear. Isn't it? F into x, this column into second column into third column, that is f into x. Last column is f into x square. Remember, it is not fx the whole square. Again, I am telling, so f into x square, it is not fx the whole square. So, second column into fourth column. F means this one, x square is this one. 7 into 625, 10 into 1225, 20 into 2025, like that. So, it is a 4375. Next, 12,250. Next, 40,500. 40,500. 54,450. 29,575. Correct, na? This much. So, which and all totals are required? Just remember, x bar we have to find. Similarly, we have to find sigma. So, for computing x bar, which one is required? For sigma fx total is, or fx total is required for computing sigma or standard deviation. F into x square column is required. Sigma f is required to compute both. So, this total is required. This is 62. Sigma fx is 2870. this total is f into x is 14 11 50. Okay, next compute. So what and all required for computing x bar and sigma is ready now. Just compute x bar and sigma. So x bar equal to sigma fx divided by capital N. That is sigma fx is 2870 divided by capital N is 62. The total, the answer is 46.29. Sigma, next sigma, I am writing here, square root of, using direct method, formula is sigma into fx square divided by sigma fx square by n minus sigma fx by n the whole square. Sigma fx square means f into x square total, this one, divided by capital N is 62 minus sigma fx. Sigma fx means this total divided by capital N is 62 the whole square. So you can compute. See, I am not doing the steps, just do in calculator. Just write the values and do in calculator. Answer is 11.5692. Next, compute CV, coefficient of variation. I am doing here. CV equal to sigma divided by x bar into 100. Sigma divided by x bar into 100. Answer is 24.99, approximately 25%. So this is the CV of first series. So class A series, CV over. So for computing here we did direct method. You can adopt any method, shortcut method or step deviation method also. Okay, no problem. So CV equal to sigma divided by x bar into 100. For computing CV, sigma is required, x bar is required. So this much indirect method, this much columns are required. So similarly, we have to compute coefficient of variation for the second one. Which one? Class B, isn't it? So class B. So class B, I'll do here only, class B. So I'll rub this. Okay, class B, I'll do here, class B. Same, that much columns are required, only the difference. What is the difference here? Yes, frequency differs here. Weights, next here also I am doing frequency itself. Next mid x, x square, next f into x, next f into x square. This much columns. So here 22, 30, 32, 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, 60 to 70. Frequency changes, frequency 5, 9, 21, 5, 9, 21, 15, 6. Okay, next midpoint, same procedure here, frequency changes. So mid-dex 25, 35, 45, 55, 65. X square also same, 625. Next 1225, 2025, 3025, 14225. Okay. Next F into X. F into X means F second column into third column. F into X I'll write. 125. Next 315. 315. Next 945. 825. 825. 390. 390. F into X square. Remember, F into X square, it is not fx the whole square. F into X square. So f into x square 3125. Next one 11025. Next one 42525. 42525. 45375. 25 3,50. Totals are, this total required, it is 62 itself, we computed earlier itself. Then F into X total is 2,600. This total is 127,400. Okay. Okay, this much clear. Now, same we did the here frequency changes because this is of class B. Next, what we have to compute? Yes, we have to compute X bar and sigma. X bar equal to sigma fx divided by capital N. Sigma fx is this total 2600 divided by capital N is 62. Then F into X square this total capital N is 62. Okay, that is for computing standard deviation. So we will do this one. Answer is 46.4285. Similarly, sigma, same formula, square root of sigma fx square divided by n minus sigma fx divided by n the whole square. Again, you have to substitute the values. F into x square, this total divided by this one minus 2600 divided by 62 the whole square, isn't it? Answer is after taking square root. So, last answer 10.9270. Next CV. CV equal to sigma divided by x bar into 100. Sigma is this one, x bar is this one into 100. Answer is 23.5351. That much a percentage. See, there are 25%. Here 23.5 or 24 we can write. So, which one is less? Yes, this one is less. Class B's CV is less. So, CV is less means that is more consistent. Or you can tell that variability is more in the first class or class A, section A. So, you can write since CV of class which one? CV of B. Which one is less? You write that one first. CV of B less than CV of A. Class B is more consistent or more homogeneous. You can write a more homogeneous also. Here more homogeneous. Correct na? CV less idre more homogeneous. If CV is more means that is less homogeneous. Okay, or less consistent. Clear it seems. So, I did using direct method. You can adopt any method. So, if you adopt any method also, you will get the same answer. Next, we will do one problem of which one? CV itself, a coefficient of variation itself. It is using less than means upper limits given and less than cumulative frequency given. First, convert it into class interval and frequencies. Next, do. Okay. Hope this one is clear to you. Okay, we will do one problem. See, calculate CV. Second problem, calculate coefficient of variation. Calculate CV. Here income, number of persons, income and number of persons, number of persons, income less than 10,000, less than 10,000, less than 15,000, less than 20,000, less than 25,000, less than 30,000. Here 80, 20, 38, 50, 60. Okay, clear na? See, what is given here? Just go to the question. Income less than 10,000, less than 50,000, less than 20,000. means which one given? Yes, upper limits are given here. Upper limits and less than cumulative frequency are given. They are upper limits. These are less than cumulative frequencies. So upper limits and less than cumulative frequencies are given. First convert it into class interval and frequencies. Next, as usual, you have to find sigma and x bar. So first solution here, income. I am writing class interval itself. You have to write income as it is. Number of persons actually f. Class interval actually less than 10,000, less than 15,000. See the difference. What is the difference here? 5,000 difference. So less than 10,000 means 10,000 is coming as upper limit. Correct na? 10,000 is coming as a upper limit. So you have to find less than 10,000 means 5,000 to 10,000. 10,000 to 15,000. 15,000 to 20,000. 5,5 difference, 5,000 difference actually. 20,000 to 25,000. 25,000 to 30,000. Correct na? These are less than cumulative frequencies, 8, 20, that and all. First frequency will be 8 itself. Next, 20 minus 8. 20 minus 8 is 12. Next, 38 minus 20, that is 18. Next, 12. Next, 10. So, nothing here. First one, 8 itself. 20 minus 8. 38 minus 20. 50 minus 38. 60 minus 50. Correct na? Next, as usual, middex. Middex, here it is 7,500. Next one, 12,500. 17,500. 22,500. Next, 27,500. Correct na? Next, what we have to compute? Yes. See, I am doing u dash here. U dash equal to x minus a divided by c. Okay. Middex, among middex, one I am taking as assumed mean. Next, I am computing. Next I am computing what? Next I am computing, taking deviation from that. So this one if I am taking means 7500 minus 17500 divided by C. C means width of class interval. Here all widths are 5000 itself divided by 5000. So it is, they took this one only. 7500 itself they took. So 7500 minus 7500 divided by 5000, it is a 0. So illi negative baru they avoid madlike, they took the first one itself, 0. Next it comes as 1, next 2, next 3, next 4. Okay, u dash. Next u dash square, if required you can write u dash square. 0, 1, 4, next 3, 3s are 9, 4, 4s are 16. Next, F into U dash. Last column, F into U dash square. Correct na? F into U dash 0, next 12, next 36, again 36, next 40. F into U dash. Hope it is clear. F into U dash. F is this one. U dash this one. 8 zeros are 0. 12 into 1, 18 into 2, 12 into 3, 10 into 4, that we wrote there. F into U dash square, remember it is not F U dash the whole square, it is F into U dash square. Second column into this column, 8 zeros are 0, 1 into 12, 12, 4 into 18, 72, correct na? So like this, it is 108, last one, it is 160. See, this total is required. It is 352 and this total also required. It is 124 and capital N however required, it is 60. So, capital N comes as a last frequency, cumulative frequency itself. Less than cumulative frequency's last value itself is our total frequency. Correct na? So next what we have to compute? X bar we have to compute. X bar equal to here A plus, here we compute adopted the deviation, step deviation method. So this is the A plus C into sigma F u dash divided by capital N. A means assumed mean, C means width of class interval, and capital N is our total frequency. Clear na? A means assumed mean. Assumed mean, we here we took the first one itself. Which one? Mid x first, 7500. So 7500 plus C means width. Width is 5000. Sigma F u dash 124. Capital N is 60. What you have to do? You have to compute this one first. You will get one value plus 7500. Answer I will write 17,833. 0.33 is there. 0.33. Next, sigma square root of sigma F into U dash square by N minus sigma F into U dash by N the whole square into C. Okay, into C is there because here we divided by C we did. Correct na? Answer I will write. I will write the direct answer. Sigma F u dash square. Hope this much. Such problems also we did. This is using step deviation method. That is the only thing. So in the step deviation method, we are taking deviation from mid x itself, midpoints. Among midpoints, one value we are taking as assumed mean. Among assumed mean, we are taking the deviations. Then divided by C is there. That is the only difference. Divided by C means width of class interval. So final answer is here 6315.85. So this much rupees, remember this is this much rupees. So income given, here also it is this much rupees. Correct na? CV equal to sigma divided by x bar into 100. Sigma divided by x bar into 100. Answer is 35.42. This much actually percentage. 35.42%. That much answer. Remember one thing. So here we took the deviations, divided by C is there. So X bar formula is this one. X bar we didn't do using this this method. Remember the formula of X bar is X bar equal to A plus C into sigma F u dash divided by capital N. So capital N is this much. Okay, sigma is this one, CV formula is answer is 35.42, that much percentage. So this much is clear. We will do some more problems of CV. CV is directly X bar kottidare, then student A, student B, mean marks kottidare, standard deviation kottidare, anta problems unto 5 marks, usually asked as 5 marks. This and all usually asked for CV problem, usually asked for 10 marks. CV all problems sa 10 marks ke keludu adnen pitkolli. This one na only for 5 the coming only for 5 marks, that we will discuss in the coming classes. Okay, thank you.